On a farm in western Iowa, surrounded by fields of corn, in the year of our Lord 1896, Merle D. Hay was born. And he learned at seed time and slaughter, as a boy at his father's right hand. Every blessing they placed on their table was from something that came to its end. He learned in the fields of Iowa what every farm boy knows: a seed must fall and be buried, that a feast for others might grow. He was 20 years when he volunteered to fight in World War I. He left his father and mother to be America's first fallen son. He was shot, he was slashed, he was fallen, but his pistol was still in his hand when his watch, a gift from his mother, stopped at 2:40 a.m. Died on the field of battle, for as every soldier knows, a seed must fall and be buried, that a feast for others might grow. Uncle Sam picked up his body from the field of mud where he fell, and carried it across the Atlantic so his mother might bid him farewell. 10,000 wept at that monument that stands off Lincoln's highway, where those with ears may stop and hear what a soldier is speaking today. Here lies in the west lawn of Glidden what every citizen knows: a seed must fall and be buried, that a feast for others might grow. A seed must fall and be buried, that a feast for others might grow.